In this video, we will discuss about 4-prism diopter test. This test is used to check bifoveal fixation, and this test is especially used in case of microtropia to detect central suppression scotoma. In this test, you will take a prism of 4-prism diopter and you will put it in front of one eye base out, and then you will observe the movement of eyes with the prism. First of all, I will tell you what happens in case of bifoveal fixation, and then we will discuss what happens in case of central suppression scotoma. In normal bifoveal fixation, both eyes are straight. I will place base out prism in front of right eye in this case. When prism is placed in front of right eye, the eyes will move towards left side. This eye will move due to prism, and this eye will follow this eye due to Herring's law. So both eyes will move towards the left side like this. Then this eye will take a refixation movement to fuse the image, and we will observe this movement. And if I observe both these movements, first both eyes move towards the left side, and then left eye move towards the right to gain fixation, it means that bifoveal fixation is present. In this case, I have put the prism in front of right eye. Now let us see what happens if I put prism in front of the left eye. When I put prism in front of the left eye, again the direction is same, base out prism, power is same, 4 prism diopters. Both eyes will move towards the right side according to Herring's law. And then the right eye moves inward to gain fixation or to fuse the images. So I will observe the movement in the right eye. So again, if this is the case, that when I place the prism in front of the left eye, both eyes move towards the right side, and then the right eye moves toward the left side to gain fixation, it means again bifoveal fixation is present. This condition is normal. Now let us discuss what happens in case of microtropia, where we suspect that central suppression scotoma is present in one eye. Now let us suppose we have a patient with a microtropia, and I suspect that there is a central suppression scotoma in the right eye. So again, I will place a base out prism in front of the eye that I suspect have a central suppression scotoma, which in this case is the right eye. The prism will move the image into the central suppression zone, where the patient cannot recognize the image. So no movement of either right eye or left eye is seen. That will give an indication that there may be central suppression scotoma present in the right eye. To be sure that this is the case, I will again shift the prism towards the left eye. Left eye is supposed to be normal. When prism is placed in front of the left eye will move towards the right side. Similarly, the right eye will move towards the right side due to Herring's law. So I will see a movement of both eyes towards the right side. The eye with suspected central suppression scotoma, the image will fall again into the central suppression zone. So no refixation movement is seen. The eye will remain there. This will give an indication that central suppression scotoma is present in the right eye. So this is how you can differentiate between bifoveal fixation and central suppression scotoma by using a 4 prism diopter test. So to summarize both conditions, for bifoveal fixation, when prism is placed in front of either eye, both eyes will move and you will see a refixation movement. In case of central suppression scotoma, if you place prism in front of the eye with suspected CSS, the eyes will not move. Or if you place the prism in front of the other eye or the normal eye, then both eyes move, but no refixation movement of the eye with suspected CSS is seen. Normally microtropia is associated with the esotropia, so therefore we use a 4 prism diopter base out. But if microtropia is associated with exotropia, then you can use base in prism, which is again 4 prism diopter, and repeat the test in the similar manner as we do in case of base out prism.